All right, welcome to How to Fix Common Errors in Sprint Mechanics. I'm Latif Thomas of CompleteSpeedTrain2.com and Complete Track and Field. And if you're not familiar with me at this point, I'll briefly go over my bio. I don't like to do long bios, and I know you don't really care. But real quick, this is a picture of me with my girls 4x100 meter relay team from this past spring. And what's important, I think, here to see is that I do not coach freaks. I coach a small private school in the suburbs. And this particular group of girls end up running 49.03 in the 4x1, which is not going to get you anywhere at nationals. But where we live with the group of kids I have when we don't have access to a track in the winter, and considering that none of these girls have broken 13 seconds fully automatic in the 100, and my anchor, who is a freshman, has a PR of 13.46, yet we were still able to go 49.03 in the 4x1. So it's a testament of when you focus on the most efficient things and the right things and address posture, mechanics, and power output, you can get some good results and you can out-coach that team that may have one or two freaks on it. And so we're going to talk about some of the most important and significant parts of those things here today. So again, very quickly, I am USTF CCA event specialist, certified in sprints, hurdles, relays, and have my USATF level 2. But let's jump in. I'm a big fan of this quote. It's going to serve as the backdrop of this presentation, and I want you to really think about it as maybe I challenge some of your views, and some of your views are challenged, or you have some new ideas, right? This quote, the reason I like it is because we have to look at the organism or the system or the process as a whole instead of focusing on very narrowly defined things that start to become digressions from our overall goal. So yes, we're going to talk about mechanics. But I'm always looking at the big picture with the mechanics and the flaws and fixes so we understand where they came from and how they manifest throughout an entire race from the block setup all the way through running through the finish line. So when you can start to understand the big picture and how little things affect big things, then we start to get a better sense of where to go with our programming. And that's really what I want to enforce on you here. We have to address mechanics, but why? Why are they slow? Right? At the end of the day, their biomotor dysfunction, right? Their inability to express speed, strength, coordination, mobility, and specific endurance is the root of all their problems. Right? Here's an athlete I had a few years ago, a little bit embarrassed to say. Here she is falling down at the end of a race. She's racing a girl she had never beaten before. And again, both of these girls made the final at the All-State Championship. But she was trying so hard, and she was in the lead for the first time, she unraveled and fell down. Right? Could not coordinate the movements correctly and falls apart. And this is an extreme example, but you're going to see a lot of the less severe versions of this with your athletes as you train them and watch them unravel. So there are three specific reasons, and there are only three reasons your sprinters fall apart in their races.